Let's take a look at the level number 2 of human evolution, which I am calling as the hedonistic level. If you take a look at the behavior of such a person, you will find that that person is always after pleasure, does not want any kind of pain, does not want to do any hard work, does not want to take any risk, and is found wherever there is pleasure. Luckily, such people, they have no survival issues. They have lots of money. Probably their parents are very rich, or they get it easily. So they have nothing to do except seek pleasure. They are mostly not interested in any kind of work. They earn using shortcuts. They get appointed in the jobs using some kind of connection, not because they are competent and talented. They are found to transfer their work to others. And when they earn money, they will earn it for pleasure only. If the money is giving them more pleasure, they are interested in earning it. Otherwise, they are not. The only fear they have is of pain and of death, because they see these two things as coming in their way of pleasure. And obviously, because of that, they are afraid of old age also. And they try to hide their age most of the time by coloring their hair or putting on a fakeness of some kind that hides their real age. They're very much attached to objects because objects give them pleasure. Not only they like objects, they use their own body as an object for pleasure. And not only their own body, they use other people as objects of pleasure. They're found to treat others as objects. They will approach you if they expect some kind of pleasure out of you. Otherwise, they are not interested. Or sometimes they will approach you to kill time because they're getting bored. They call you or they message you looking for some entertainment. That's all. So you get a good picture of them in these few lines. And you must have recalled many people that you have met who are at this level. When you look at their speech, they only talk about what they did for pleasures. They went here and they ate that and they had this girlfriend now and so on. Which movie is playing in which theater? Which is the best music? Which is the coolest kind of clothing available? Designer clothing? Most expensive shoes? They talk about only these things. And they mention that he or she wants that and how nice it would be if they had something like this. Anything that can provide pleasure, they talk about it. And sometimes they worry about pain, and if something is troubling them, something is not giving them pleasure, they worry about these things and they express these things through the speech. And they're found to complain when the pleasures are withdrawn. And their gossip is not boring, just like the animalistic people. Their gossip is very juicy, very entertaining. They become good talkers, good entertainers. And they entertain others because they get entertained themselves. They find it very, very entertaining. Produces emotional juice in them. It does not matter what topic you start, whether it is intellectual or political or anything. They will come back to the expression of desires. Or they will come back to which actor did what and which actress looks best. Something like this. And they always talk about what they want instead of discussing a subject. So you can see the ego is very strong here, and the ego is totally involved in hedonistic behavior. You don't even need to sometimes look at their behavior. Simply talking on phone or a brief interaction can tell you. Sometimes a single photo is enough to tell you what kind of person that is. But as we know, we do not judge so quickly. And although they have nothing new to talk, they always find somebody who is interested. Because who is not interested in pleasures? So as they grow old, they start repeating the same things again and again and again. And it is mostly lies which are spiced up. If you examine the thought of such a person, you will find their imaginations of pleasure and happiness. Air castles. Always think about something which can give them pleasure of some kind. Bodily pleasure or any other sensual pleasures. They do plan to get the objects they desire. Otherwise, how are they going to get the objects? So there is a bit of planning going on. And if they do not plan, if they do not expect any kind of pleasure, or they plan to avoid pain, and beyond that, their mind is mostly inactive. They are unable to think anything beyond that. They do not understand most of the sophisticated talk, and they fall asleep as soon as you talk anything more than pleasures and pains. The mind shuts down immediately. The mind is fully corrupted by pleasure-seeking activities. And they wake up as soon as you mention something which can fulfill their desires. And some people can exploit this kind of people because of lack of intelligence and so much force of desires. They are ready to do anything to get their desires fulfilled. They are ready to do anything for pleasure. So when I warned you that this method that we are using to evaluate people and ourselves can be misused, this is what I meant. It can be misused. And many people do that. Many people are very cunning and manipulative. And such hedonistic people fall prey to them easily. If you look at their relations, and you must have guessed it, that they are faithful to somebody as long as the relation provides pleasure, happiness, comforts, money, security, and fulfills their demands and desires. And they are not interested in the person, they are interested in themselves, fulfillment of their desires and pleasures. The person, the relation, is only a means to get it. And they shift to a better source of pleasure immediately. You will find that such people have many affairs in their lives. They are not satisfied in even one of them. And they keep switching. And they keep going to the old partners in case they don't find anybody new for a long time. They are kind of shameless about it. And if you look at the ancient times, they had many wives. Actually, a person who could support many wives was considered a reputed person somehow in the ancient times. And obviously, he did not keep so many wives just as a social service, just to feed them. Either they became a source of pleasure or they became servants. And the babies he got from those wives, they became slaves. Many sons, they earned the money. And that fellow was probably rich. That is why they got an image of a wealthy person, a big fat person with many wives who does nothing, is always found eating and gossiping. And those who did not get that kind of status were found to lust after that kind of life. And you will find people like that today also. Their ideals are such hedonistic people. People who are always on vacations, always covered in expensive clothing, and always are shown having pleasure of some kind on the covers of the magazines or on TV or somewhere else, internet. These are ideals for hedonistic people. And you can guess that they are not really faithful about anything. They dump people every day. They are not trustworthy for relations. Although when you don't pay any attention, they are ready to lick your feet if they can get something out of you. And the relations are give and take. You give me this much, I'll give you that much. And they are not only good pleasure takers, they are also good pleasure givers. And so they only mix with their own kind. There is no regard for the blood relatives. Unlike in the case of animalistic people, where the blood relatives are probably the strongest bonds, hedonistic people, they disregard the blood relatives if they provide them with money or food or mates. Then they have a little bit of regard, otherwise not. However, they are very friendly because they seek only pleasure and nothing else. They become good friends. If you are something similar, if you also seek pleasure, if you are able to give and take pleasure, you will find that such people are very friendly. Although the friendship is kind of superficial, they will dump you the next second. But as long as they are friends, they are very good. Even if fake friendship, it is very good. Normally, they won't cause any kind of harm or they won't attach to you because they consider themselves as free. And in parties and in ceremonies and in get-togethers, these people, they form very good and interesting company. They have a lot to tell. They joke around and they are covered in very interesting clothes and have objects to show off. new watch, a new expensive phone or things like that. And they actually go to the parties and social events just to show off, not because they're social. They're not really social. Because they're pleasure-seeking, they maintain their bodies. They are very beautiful and they are very attractive from the looks point of view. They never let their bodies fall sick or become obese, and mostly people are attracted to them because of that look. When they start getting old, obviously, they do all kinds of tricks to not appear old. And they get into a delusion of some kind that I am not really old. Their behavior becomes really odd as they grow old. If you look at their entertainment, the major entertainment for them is sex. And if they are not doing that, and they are found eating heavy food because the light, normal food is not pleasurable enough. So they need new things to eat, and the heavier and more expensive, the better. So they are heavy consumers of food. It is not that they will eat a lot, just like the animalistic people. They are not interested in quantities. They are interested in quality. So very sweet or very spicy or very oily, fatty foods. They are always ready for vacation. It is their entertainment. They don't want to do any work. So if they are sufficiently rich, they spend all their money on vacations. They keep a lot of servants because they don't want to work. They become addicted to alcohol or drugs. Why? Because they seem to provide them with pleasure of some kind. Their brains and bodies, they get addicted to pleasure. And in the old age, or if they are not so rich and good looking, their source of entertainment is pornography or very cheap entertainment. Novels and stories and movies of this kind, where the pleasure is the main business of the writer and characters. You can judge the book by a cover, because many books are written for such people. Many movies are made for such people, where in every other shot there is nudity or somebody smoking or drinking alcohol. Every other frame is like this of that movie. Or there is a very big car there, or the woman gets the ideal man in the end, who is very handsome, good looking and very rich, and is always cracking jokes. So that is their entertainment. It is kind of very entertaining, but nothing more than that. It is all good till they get the mental afflictions, because such a lifestyle will lead to consequences eventually. They are very cunning. They will do almost anything to get the pleasures. They can lie endlessly to keep the sources of pleasure. They are cheaters. They are corrupt. They are dishonest people. They will do anything to keep their business going or their job going. Backstabbing and accusing others of mistakes and so on. You'll find them everywhere. And they are dripping with lust all the time. And they use force and violence to fulfill their lusty desires. Not only manipulation, not only lies. They can torture the person. Because the lust is too much. The lust got distorted so much that a simple affair is not giving them any pleasure. For pleasure, they will do any kind of crime, and then if somebody finds it out, they are even ready to kill that person. They want to hide their crimes. And another common mental affliction is that they are addicted to many things. Almost everything is an addiction for them. Whether it is hot baths, soaps, perfumes, gold, heavy makeup, or whether alcohol, drugs, cigarettes, food. Some are habitual liars. And they waste all of their money on these things, which is some kind of mental affliction. Sometimes when there is no money and they are not able to keep up that kind of lifestyle, they become suicidal. An animalistic person is not going to kill himself, but these people, they can. The only more suicidal category is the emotional kind of category. When they can experience pleasure to such a degree, they can experience the pain to a very high degree. And a normal person won't experience the pain to that degree. Even the smallest situation which is painful becomes a big deal for them. It becomes a trauma for them. And if you are thinking that, wait a minute, I know so many people who are like this. Yes, a big portion of humanity is nothing but hedonistic people. That is what they stamp as success. Your society is going to give you a medal of success if you become hedonistic. Oh, you have everything now, the food and house and everything. And now you're engaged in a pleasure-seeking behavior. And they will say, what is wrong in that? He's successful. And you will see such symbolism everywhere. In newspapers, in advertisements, in TV, in movies. The pleasure-seeking man is the ideal for our societies. Why is that? Because most of them are on the animalistic level and they want to progress to the next level, which is hedonistic. And therefore, these majority, they brand this kind of behavior as a sign of success. Yes, there are some good factors here. I mean, it is not a crime to like things or to gain pleasure sometimes. And it is not bad to avoid pain. Why should I go for pain? I should avoid it, yes. If you think that nothing else is happening in your life except this and the activities below this, then you can be sure that you are stuck at the level number two. You are not progressing beyond this. So what can be done for a man who is trapped in senses? Of course, they do not know they are trapped. A lower layer does not know anything about the higher layers. The higher layers knows everything about the lower layers. The lower layer does not control anything up there. But the higher layers, they control everything below them. So by themselves, they do not progress. What happens is that when you tell them that, look, this kind of behavior is lowly behavior, their answer is no. What is wrong in looking good? What is wrong in parties? What is wrong in having partners? Girls like me, so what? Why are you jealous? The problem is that that does not last. And the next phase arrives. Like the moon grows for 15 days and then it diminishes for 15 days. So when the dark phase arrives, they suffer a lot. And this suffering propels them towards higher layers. Otherwise, they are not able to see anything beyond the pleasures. And there also only a few get the chance. The others are just engaged in pain avoidance. That's all they do. They do the damage control when the damage has already happened. So if you think, oh, I am also engaged in many of these things, don't worry. It can happen in a small way when the age is right and when the time is right and when all the desires are getting fulfilled without any problems. These things are okay. This is a part of being human. But if this is your dominant theme in your life, nothing else is happening in your life, then probably you are stuck here. And what can be done except suffering? There are some recommended paths here. The first is, of course, devotion. Such a person needs to see devotion as a source of pleasure, and then the worldly pleasures, they are dropped. Or they can join a religious community, any kind of religion they like, and adopt the lifestyle that the religion recommends. Don't drink too much, don't eat too much, have only one wife, be celibate, do not steal, do not lie. This is what religions teach us, and they are tailored for such people. It is kind of recommended thing to join the religions. But, you know, these days it can backfire very easily. For some people, the path of actions is also recommended. Because they are very lazy, they do not want to work. A little bit of service is recommended. And they can do it for pleasure. Yes. Slowly, serving others become more pleasure than selfishness. And that causes a little bit of progress. Usually, it is a hopeless place to be. An animalistic person will very easily progress to the hedonistic because it has the attraction, it has the power in it. But there is no motivation for a hedonistic person to go above it. Where is the motivation when you are getting all the pleasures? So service is recommended, path of action is recommended. If there are too many desires, then the occult paths are recommended, where you get your desires fulfilled very quickly by hook or crook. And the rest of the life of the causal body is then goes in damage control that the occult path delivered. So what the occult path does is it produces instant gratification of desires, gives you instant pleasure. And we know very well that human mind gets bored of that thing. If it is coming instantly, If it is available everywhere like dirt, we don't want it. We want something which nobody has. And the ochre gives you everything. And so we quickly lose interest in all kinds of pleasures and cheap things and useless relations. That causes a vacuum in front of the person, and the vacuum pulls the person forward. The vacuum sucks them into a higher level. But these things are kind of must be recommended on a case-to-case basis. I'm just giving you a general outline here. What can be done about these people generally? They can be prescribed a form of yoga, which is something very simple, which they can handle, like two or three limbs of the Ashtang Yoga, if they can manage, up to the Pratyahar or avoidance of sensual pleasures. It can be taught under a teacher to cultivate the intention, a strong intention to not waste their energies in pleasure-seeking activities. Now you know the secret behind some of the yogic practices which kind of ban all kind of pleasure for the seeker. It is not for everyone. It is for hedonistic level. That nothing works for them except forceful termination of these activities. Why will such a person do that? No, they don't do it. There has to be reason. Either the suffering is too much, or there is a spark of consciousness there which tells them that something is wrong in this life. Probably somebody dies in their family, or one of their partner dies, or they start getting old and they can see the death standing on their front door. It's about to ring the bell, and then the bell rings in their mind that probably I need to now balance these things. And they approach the guru and they approach the teacher, and probably guru is going to prescribe them something like this, very light kind of yogic practices. Usually many lifetimes will be spent on this level. They are also very new. Their causal bodies have just been promoted into human category, and now they are exploring the human body and human world. So even a teacher knows this, that it has a momentum, and then the momentum will pull that person out of this stage. But yes, it can take a long time. And if you're born in a specific kind of time and era where the prosperity is everywhere, then it will take even more time. You will spend hundreds of lives taking births in that age. So anyway, not everything is dark and gloomy here, and they have a future, but it is going to be a long journey.